Hi everyone. So in your wildest dreams and probably your nightmares, have you ever wondered hiring a dentist to photograph one of your biggest days of your life? So my name is Manoj Nair and I'm a fine art and minimalistic wedding photographer and I'm also a full-time dentist. So being a full-time dentist and a wedding photographer isn't easy juggling my two different worlds together, but I'm very fortunate and blessed to have met many different couples and also colleagues who have made this journey a much more rewarding journey. Okay, to be honest, I never really imagined coming this far as a photographer. And back then, it was just shooting for some of my friends, you know, in high school. It was when I went to college to do my A-levels. I joined the Help Photography Club and I met this guy called Joshua Yap. So I managed to join him for a couple of weddings, and that's where I learned a lot from the photography aspects of wedding. And eventually, I managed to get a few weddings on my own as well. I would say that my photography style is a lot more natural and candid, you know. My idea of shooting weddings is it should be very simple and classy. So when you look back at your photos 10 to 20 years down the road, it should give you that same warm, nostalgic feeling when you see your wedding photos. And I think that's what I strive for every weekend. Just keeping it simple, classy, nothing too much, and just to celebrate the love itself between the couple. Yeah. So for me, I don't really conceptualize most of the wedding shoots on that day because for me, I just leave it to the couple to decide on their wedding style and preference. But for most of my pre-wedding, yes, I do have a team that discuss with the couple regarding the style that they like. So some couples prefer a more outdoor kind of theme, some prefer more indoor, some like more greenery, some like the beach. Yeah. So and then we will adapt, you know, to how their outfit will be, how the makeup will be and stuff. So I think it's good to talk to the couple a lot to conceptualize on a style that is on the same page with everyone. That way it's a lot more easier for you to get a better outcome in the end of the day, you know. So I think right now online exposure is very important, you know, for wedding photographers. And I think when I first started to go, Instagram was just sort of a new thing and not everyone was on Instagram yet. But right now you can just literally click a few buttons on your smartphone and ta-da, you know, the photos are up there already. Even on Facebook and Instagram, it's so easy to share your photos on social media. Right now, the wedding photography market is very saturated. Yeah. Don't be too caught up with the number of followers and the number of likes and all that. You know, just be true to yourself and focus on sharing more content on your social media. I would say that 90% of my couples book me through Instagram, and that's where I would say I'm most active at. And I dedicate like a few hours every day to reply inquiries, to post photos, create new contents, and also just to engage with my followers as well. Another way to gain more exposure online is to collaborate with other wedding vendors, you know, such as event planners, wedding decorators, makeup artists. I think together as a team, you will be able to achieve a lot more as compared to one individual. And that way you can reach out to a greater and wider range of audience as well. So I guess, you know, one of the most asked questions I get is how do I juggle my time between a full-time wedding photographer and a full-time dentist? And my advice is to myself is to always prioritize doing one thing at one time. Yeah, when I get my bookings for the year, I will block out a few weekends first to make sure that I don't swamp my entire calendar with too much of weddings or too much of clinical work as well. That way I get to plan ahead of time. I can sort out some weekends for holidays or to just spend time with family, or most importantly, just spend time for myself, you know. Yeah, because it's very important to keep yourself steady and also to keep yourself healthy mentally and physically as well. So finding that sweet spot of balance between a full-time job and also your side hustle as a wedding photographer is very important. Yeah. I guess there are a few ways you can prepare yourself. Number one, I would say is for me personally, I always meet up with all my couples first and just lay flat all the information and all the expectations from the couple, and so that we're all on the same page. Also for me to get to know them better as a couple as well. You know, I think it can be very awkward sometimes as a photographer when you just meet the couple on the wedding day. It's good to build a relationship with them, like a friendship, you know, to before you start shooting them on their wedding. And I realized that most of the time that helps in getting better photos as well. Yeah. Another way is to do some second shooting as well. You will get a lot of experience, you know, on how to shoot a wedding day. You can learn from the main photographer how they manage the couple, how they pose the couple, and how, if you were to put yourself in that situation, how would you do it differently as well. So as a second shooter and photographer, you get to learn a lot of things and see how the wedding story unfolds throughout the day. Another way for you to prepare yourself is to go on YouTube. You know, I think right now there's a lot of wedding photographers out there who are very kind-hearted and generous to share their content on YouTube to how they shoot their entire wedding day. And I think it's amazing for you to be able to experience that, you know, just through the computer. That will really prep you and your mind before you shoot this wedding day. Yeah. Never take up a wedding if you are not sure of a lot of things yet. You know, always prepare yourself first and lay out the expectations, and eventually you will get better in that. In a wedding day, a lot of things don't go as you turn out to be, and you don't have a second chance to repeat it. So as a professional, you have to be very prepared to shoot as it is and to just adapt in different kind of environments and situations as well. For me, I'm a totally paranoid photographer, and for me, I always prepare everything like a day or two beforehand, you know. So I think it's good to do a lot of research in terms of the location, in terms of how you plan to run your shoot throughout the day, to brief your team as well. And there's quite a number of work that I do before a wedding day just to make sure that everything goes smoothly. I always shoot with a second photographer and a team of photographers so that in case if anything goes wrong, I always have a backup to assist me as well. I will always focus on the couple first, and maybe my assistant and second shooters can shoot the guests or the family members to get a better picture of how the wedding went throughout the day. For me, I always maintain a good and healthy lifestyle, try to get enough hours of sleep before a wedding day, and just to prepare myself mentally regarding the shoot. For me, when I plan out my weddings, I also plan out what kind of lenses and cameras to bring. But most of the time, I bring a series of lenses, so for me to be able to cover different kind of setup environment as well. So I have a series of lenses that I use, and over the years I accumulated them. Most of them are for wedding purposes. Yeah, so I'll just go through a few lenses that I primarily use. So the first lens would be the Canon EF 1635mm f2.8L Mark II. Yeah, basically it is a wide-angle zoom lens for me to shoot group photos and wide-angle shots of the wedding day as well, to get the whole picture of the ceremony going on. And I would say that that's usually on my second body most of the time. So my main lens, or my most favorite lens, would be the Canon EF 50mm 1.2L. I love the 1.2 capabilities for low light, and also it's a really fast and sharp lens. Yeah, I use it like 90% of the time for my portraits, for the bride getting ready, for the groom getting ready. Yeah. And I would say that 90% of the time it's on my main body. I do have two other lenses, which is the 24mm EF, Canon EF 24mm f1.4L. And also the Canon EF 35mm 1.4L. So these two lenses are a little bit more wider, and for me to get a bigger perspective of the day. Yeah. And I really love the sharpness of both of the lenses, yeah, and the bokeh that it produces as well. Yeah. For me, I'm also having other lenses for dinner receptions mainly, yeah, which is the Canon EF 85mm 1.2L. It is a really old lens, but I really love the 1.2 and the bokeh, and also the sharpness that it produces. Yeah. I use it a lot for low light performances and low light dinner receptions, and I think it really gives a different kind of look to the photos. Yeah. And lastly, I have the Canon EF 100mm f2.8L IS macro lens, yeah, which is, I use it a lot for the close-up shots, for the ring shots, to get very fine details of a wedding day. And in fact, I even use it for my dental photography as well. So it's a very versatile lens for me. I think every photographer has their own preference. For me, I've been very used to using prime lenses, yeah. And I love the bokeh that it gives, and also the depth of field that it produces from each lens. So that's why I use a lot of prime lenses. And it's also much lighter for me for during a wedding day as well. Yeah. A lot of photographers tell me that gears don't matter. To me, to a certain extent, I do believe that. But I also do believe that gears do matter, and I think it helps us to get better photos in the end of the day, you know. For young photographers, maybe getting all the lenses at one time may be too much, you know. So one way to go about it is to try different lenses. Try through a friend, or to maybe go to a camera rental shop and try out the lens first before jumping the trigger and getting the camera and lens. Sometimes you may not really need the most expensive lens or the best lens, but something that can just help you to push yourself to get better photos, you know. So you can try more affordable Canon lenses such as the EF lenses first before jumping towards the L lenses. Recently, throughout the months, I started shooting with the new Canon EOS R6. Yeah, so the Canon R6 is a full-frame mirrorless camera recently launched by Canon, and I was taking some time before I considered to jump through it because I was always so used to using DSLRs for a long time. But right now, I think the mirrorless technology has come a long way, and I was truly impressed by the performance. You know, the autofocus, the flip screen, and the frames per second, and most importantly, it's lightweight. You know, I can shoot the entire wedding through the Canon R6 and I don't feel anything on my back and my shoulders as well. Alright, so my last advice to new photographers starting out, I think I was very blessed to be able to have a very good mentor who guided me. In 2016, I joined this photography company called Monkey Studio. So Monkey is one of the top 10 wedding photographers in Malaysia, and it's more than just his photos. I think it's his personality and the energy that he brings throughout the wedding that really inspires me. I give full respect for him. So as a new photographer, I think it can be a very stressful and daunting thing, you know, for photographers to start out in the world of weddings as well. But I think ultimately when I look back, it is all to make me who I am today, you know. It's all a learning experience, and for you to just go through the process of becoming a better photographer as well. And most importantly as a photographer is to have fun, you know, just keep shooting. Yeah.
Canon, delighting you always.